Namaste viewers, welcome to Jnana Degula channel. In the Agama traditions, there are innumerable Agamas. Among them, in this video, we will see two of them. One is Soura Agama and the other one is Ganapati Agama. Soura Agama, Soura means related to sun. Sun worship. Soura Agama, they are scriptures which relate to the worship of the sun. Sun is known as Surya, Mitra, Bhanu, so many names. They outline the rituals, prayers and philosophies related to the sun worship, Soura Agamas. Here you have Saura Tantras also. These Saura Tantra texts form the foundation of the Soura Agamas. They provide insights into the spiritual significance of the sun and offer guidelines for practitioners of sun worship, Soura Agamas. You have some Agama religions. The Soura Agamas are part of the broader Agamic traditions in Hinduism. It's a part of it, which includes various sects and schools of thought centered around the specific deities or principles. Agamas are specific deities. This Surya, the sun god, holds a prominent place in Hindu mythology and spirituality. Soura Agamas delve into different aspects of Surya's symbolism, attributes and worship practices. Surya is often considered or revered as a great and divine entity. It represents light, energy, vitality, everything. Without Surya, nothing can be there. That is for sure. The Soura Agamas explore the spiritual significance of the sun as a symbol of enlightenment and cosmic power. This is the solar reverence. You have this temple rituals also. The Soura Agamas provide instructions for conducting rituals and ceremonies in temples dedicated to Surya. These rituals aim to invoke the blessings of the sun god and promote spiritual growth and growth among devotees. There is one more known as Ganapatya Agama. That is relating to worship of Ganapati. They are also religious texts focused on the worship of Lord Ganesha. Ganesha with the elephant headed deity revered as the remover of obstacles and the god of beginnings. Whenever you do any puja, you are ordered to first complete the Ganapati worship. After performing the Ganapati puja, only then you can go to the next worship of the other deities. Now, here the sectarian tantras. These texts are part of the broader tantric tradition within Hinduism. They specifically cater to Ganapati sect. They emphasize unique rituals and practices associated with Ganesha worship. These devotional texts are also there, where the Ganapatya Agamas contain hymns, hymen or hymn or whatever you call it, shlokas or mantras, prayers and some philosophical teachings aimed at fostering devotion to Lord Ganesha and promoting spiritual growth among followers. There are a lot of hymns. Jnana, Anpa, Ganapati, like this, you know, Vakratunda, Mahakaya, Surya, Kotisam, like this, so many prayers are there and philosophical teachings also. Ganapati or Ganesha Atharva Shirsha. Ganapati Atharva Shirsha is, I think, a later addition to the mantras. But it highlights Ganapati and then it attributes all the qualities to the Ganapati. Now, Ganesha worship has been an integral part of Hindu tradition for centuries, with Lord Ganesha being venerated by people from various backgrounds and sects within Hinduism. Everybody, they worship Ganesha. The existence of Ganapatya Agama alongside other Agamic texts reflects the diverse religious landscape within Hinduism, with the different sects following distinct traditions and practices. Viewers, with this we conclude the Ganapati Agama and then Soura Agama traditions. Please like, share and then subscribe to our channel. Thank you.